Let's take a look at the concept of arising out of employment. Workers' compensation is intended to deal with work-related injuries and illnesses, specifically those that arise out of and in the course of employment. The requirement that the injury or illness occur in the course of employment refers to the time, place, and setting in which it occurs. Arising out of employment refers to the underlying causation of the injury or illness. These phrases seem simple, but they have been the object of much litigation and variability across states in how these phrases are interpreted. Many circumstances raise questions about whether injuries or illnesses arose in the course of employment. Travel by employees outside of commuting to and from work also raises questions about coverage. Injuries that occur while employees are attending to personal activities are generally considered to be in the course of employment and compensable. Brief departures from work activities to attend to personal needs are to be expected. However, employees who are injured while under the influence of drugs or alcohol on the job are usually viewed as having abandoned their jobs and are not entitled to workers' compensation. In cases of injuries caused by coworker misconduct, non-participating employees who are injured by the horseplay or pranks of other employees are generally entitled to workers' compensation. Misbehavior that results in injury but does not constitute a substantial departure from required tasks is likely to be compensable. To be covered by workers' compensation, injuries must not only occur in the course of employment, but they also must arise out of employment. Although these two requirements tend to coincide, this is not always the case. The most restrictive view, the peculiar risk doctrine, finds that injuries or illnesses arise out of employment only if they are much more common to people performing particular types of work. Under the somewhat less restrictive increased risk doctrine, an injury or illness arises out of employment if the employee's work or work environment measurably increased his chances of being harmed over that of the general public. Still broader coverage occurs when courts employ the actual risk doctrine, under which injuries or illnesses are compensable so long as the harm that occurred is a risk of the job, even though the general public might be similarly at risk. The broadest coverage occurs under the positional risk doctrine, where injuries or illnesses are generally covered, provided that the harm would not have occurred unless their job placed them in the position in which they were harmed. Heart attacks and back injuries present problems in terms of deciding whether they arose out of employment. These conditions are common, have many causes, and might simply be aggravated by the demands of employment. Most courts follow the usual exertion rule, under which such injuries are compensable if the normal demands of employees' jobs are such that they might reasonably result in injury. Psychological conditions that follow from physical injuries and psychological stresses that are caused by physical harm are likely to be compensated.